Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. In this episode, let's look at how you can do advanced math calculations with Spotlight. Now, you probably already know about, and you may use all the time, Spotlight's ability to do simple math. So I'm going to bring up Spotlight. I'm not going to use this. I'm going to use Command Space because you want to do this quickly and simply as possible. Command Space is the best way to get to Spotlight. And you can do simple math here. So 1 plus 2, and it gives you the result. Now, you probably also know that you can do, of course, subtraction. You can do multiplication. I'm using the asterisk key, which is above the number 8. You can do division. And you can get the answer. But there's actually a lot more that you can do. You can do most of what's available in most calculators. As a matter of fact, maybe even a little bit more if you just know the right functions to use. So the first function I want to show you is the square root. Suppose you wanted to find the square root of a number. You could use the function sqrt, and then you put in parentheses what you want to find the square root of. So 9 gives you 3, 10 gives you 3.16, etc. There's also a cube root function, cbrt. And likewise, you could find the power by simply using the caret symbol, which is shift 6 on most keyboards. So for instance, 2 to the third or 2 to the fourth. And you could do roots with this as well. So if I wanted to do 9 and then I want to find the square root of it, I can do it by 0.5 or 1/2 and get the correct answer. A cube root of say 27, I can do 1 divided by 3. So you can go to even deeper roots if you want as well. There are functions that deal with rounding. So normally you wouldn't need help rounding, but say if you were doing something like the square root of 15, but you wanted it to be rounded to the nearest integer, you could put a function around that so you can nest functions. And you could do ceil, C-E-I-L for ceiling, and it rounds it up to 4. Or you could do floor, and it will round it down. Likewise, rint, round integer, will round something up or down. So 7.2 rounds to 7, where 7.8 rounds up to 8. You also have absolute value function, FABS. So of 9 is 9, and of negative 9, it's also 9. You've got a pretty full set of trigonometry functions as well. So you have sine, you've got cosine, you've got tangent. You could also do arcsine, A-S-I-N, and a cosine and arctangent as well. And even hyperbolic sines, just add an H to sine, cosine, or tangent, and you can do arc hyperbolic sines, cosines, and tangents as well. You've got some exponential functions and logarithms. So exp is the natural exponent. You can use log to get a base 10 logarithm. And ln for natural logarithm. You can also write numbers with an e. So for instance, 60e6. Pads with 6 zeros. There are also at least two constants that Spotlight knows. There's pi, just the two letters p and I, and e, and knows that as well. And there are a few symbols that you can use. For instance, you can use an exclamation point for a factorial. So for instance, 5 factorial 120, 6 factorial 720, etc. And you have modulus using the percent symbol. So for instance, if you want to do 9 mod 2, or mod 4, 5, 19, you can do that as well. And you can use parentheses as much as you want. So for instance, you can do 5 plus 7 plus 8 times 4 to better define exactly what it is that you mean when doing a more complex formula. But there's still more. You can use percent as a percent, not just modulus. So for instance, you know, 4 mod 2 is going to do that. But if you would use it like this, like say you're calculating, let's see, on a $50 bill, what is 7% for tax? And in that case, it understands that you mean percent, not mod. Also, for the trigonometric functions, you are using, of course, radians for those, as you do with most computers. But you can actually use degrees as well, because there are these other functions where you could do sine with degrees and say 45. And it understands that with that D there that you mean degrees. And one last thing that I think is really cool is you don't have to use the multiplication symbol all the time. You can write things out like you may actually write them out in math class, or if you use math a lot for work like I do. So for instance, you can do this. No multiplication sign right there because it's implied. You can do the same thing with functions. And the multiplication there is implied. Just like that.